Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Astronomers estimate that there are trillions of planets in the universe, but so far, the Earth is the only planet we know of that has ever had life. Life is fragile. Biologists estimate that more than 98% of all animals, the plants, and other types of species that had ever existed are now extinct. Unlike Mars and other planets that we have studied, the Earth has 5 major systems that interact with each other and appear to make life possible. Those systems are the atmosphere, biosphere, geosphere, hydrosphere, and magnetosphere. The atmosphere is the air that surrounds the Earth. In this photo, we can see the atmosphere from outer space as the thin blue layer between the aerotips. Outer space is defined as being 100 kilometers above sea level, which equals 62 miles high. That means the atmosphere is at least 62 miles high, though many scientists consider the atmosphere 300 miles high, since there is still detectable air. If you've ever looked out a plane window when it is 6 miles above the ground, you may have noticed this transition from lighter blue near the ground to a darker blue as the atmosphere fades towards outer space. There are many small rocks in outer space called meteoroids. When these enter the Earth's atmosphere, they are called meteors, and we can see these as white streaks as they burn up in the atmosphere. The few meteors that make it through the atmosphere and land on Earth are then called meteorites, like this one that landed in Arizona. Most meteorites contain iron, so are attracted to magnets. The atmosphere is all the air around us. It includes the air we breathe and the air we feel when we run or when the wind is blowing. It is the atmosphere that makes it possible for birds, planes, and kites of all sizes to fly. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. The biosphere is the sphere that contains all the life on Earth, regardless of its type, form, or size. The biosphere includes the tiniest organisms that we can only see with powerful microscopes, such as these plankton-like ones and even smaller ones, such as these bacteria colored pink, that are magnified over 50,000 times. On the other side's extreme, the biosphere includes huge elephants, whales, and giant trees. Regardless of whether an organism spends a lot of time soaring in the atmosphere like these birds, or cannot move, like these coral, on the ocean floor, if it is alive, then it's part of the biosphere. That also means that you and I, along with all other humans, are part of the biosphere. Organisms that have died recently but are not yet recycled by their ecosystem, such as these leaves, are also part of the biosphere. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. The geosphere is the Earth's land, but not the water or life on that land. This includes mountains, but not the frozen water they have, such as snow or ice. It also includes hills and plains, but not the life on them, such as grass or trees. And it includes deserts, but as before, we exclude these camels, the vegetation, and any water there. In oceans, of which many are 5 to 7 miles deep, we often cannot see the geosphere unless we dive deep. But the geosphere does include the floors of oceans, lakes, and rivers. At the North Pole, there is a thin layer of frozen ice floating on the Arctic Ocean. That means the ground we see is just ice and is not part of the geosphere. But deep below that ice surface is the ocean floor, which it is part of the geosphere. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. The hydrosphere is all the water on Earth but excludes the life that lives in it. We classify water as salt water or fresh water. As the name suggests, salt water contains salt and is all the water in the oceans, which stores 97% of the Earth's water. Fresh water is the name we use for water without salt and includes most lakes, rivers, and all glaciers. Since 97% of the Earth's water is salt water, that means 3% of the Earth's water is fresh water. Of that 3%, 2% is stored in enormous glaciers, so most of the Earth's fresh water is stored in glaciers. That means less than 1% of the Earth's water is not in the oceans or glaciers, that remaining 1%, is all the water in lakes, rivers, and underground sources. Since the clouds contain millions of gallons of water in its vapor form, scientists include clouds in the hydrosphere, though clouds are often considered part of the atmosphere too. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. As the name suggests, the magnetosphere is the magnetic field that surrounds and protects the Earth. Like other magnetic fields, we cannot see it directly. But these aurora, sometimes called northern lights, are made when the Earth's magnetic field blocks tiny particles in outer space from hitting the Earth. Those tiny particles come from the Sun by traveling in the solar wind. The magnetosphere protects the Earth with its invisible shield. The magnetic field around the Earth is due to liquid iron deep inside the Earth, which acts like a giant magnet. We can detect the Earth's magnetic field with a simple compass like this. Some animals, such as birds, can also detect the magnetic field, which is how they find their way when migrating thousands of miles over water without any landmarks. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Although each of these five spheres is amazing by itself, when they interact with each other, we see spectacular results, such as the three famous Earth cycles, which are the carbon cycle, the rock cycle, and the water cycle. We'll cover each of these cycles in separate videos. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.